All right. Take a look at this right here. Well, just use your 5/16 bit and just loosen it up.
No, use your drill. Now, is that a 5/16 bit?
Is it supposed to be able to slide on the tighter one?
Okay. Yeah, it looks good.
Does it have a slide?
Yeah, it's not too tight.
Do you drill anything in there? Is it a bit, or do you have to just turn it off? Okay. Mine's definitely not fitting in.
Looks good. When you work it, it'll just a little bit.
Just go back and forth, and just go back and forth a little more. Yes, we do. In our grub screw repository, which is around this other side. Yeah, that's the thing that, so if you notice, there's a little bump on each side, right? That's where the screw, little screw goes in.
A little black screw in, so let me grab that screw.
What's next? What's next? I'm reading.
Thank you.
On both sides. On
each side there should be two.
Oh. Wait, so. Thank you.
So when we do this axis, let's put on a stepper motor. So take out four of them. We have to take off this shock absorber. I can just do that around. Take out, unbox four of them, so you do it all at the same time. Save the wire, you got these two things in there. Save them, put them in your box. And otherwise, throw out the box of cardboard. Stepper motors. In the cardboard boxes. You got, there's some around the other side. So the little shock absorber, you just need a Phillips bit, take that off. We don't need that. I'll walk around, I'll do that. We don't want to strip those little screws. Save the shock absorbers and little screws, throw them in your box. Well, after you get them off, yeah. Screws, if you strip them, you can't get them out. That's why I did that for everybody. But you just need a T2 bit. They're really small. It looks like you might need a smaller bit, but it's a regular T2 Phillips. Did you do this? Did you take the shock absorbers off? No, you got shipped without them, right?
So,
It didn't come with those? What did it come with?
They just came like that.
Oh, like this, yes. Yes. How does the motor mount? It's so on this is the motor piece. You're gonna do like a diamond pattern, but that means you gotta drill out those three diamond patterns with an 1/8 inch, 3mm bit. The 3mm bits are in this pile here.
Are they
the ones that are the small ones, the smallest ones there. Okay. Those are 3mm. So do that. And that way you can mount the motor. So now we need the motor screws. Towards actually most convenient is to the back, because when I have the
back right or back left,
either the back. Well, but you gotta know which is front and back. So which is front and back?
The side that's closer to the big one.
So which is front and back? Logic there is the front is the part that's got the divider. That's how all of them have it. Like this one. Well,
yeah.
The one with the divider is the front.
What length of M3s do you use?
these ones right here. So we need 12 each. So everybody grab 12 of these, or 3 times 3, 9. How many 9? One of these. We'll put them. They're right here. 9 of those.
Yeah, we do.
And those are the tiny ones that are in his bag, right here. So, those are 2 millimeters.
And so we just screw from the back.
Yeah. I don't know what. Yeah.
So we're outside.
And the flange of the motor has to sit inside the hole.
Are you sure these are long enough?
Yeah, because they are recessed. They end up, you kind of got to clear a little bit above them, but that's a recessed hole. Yeah.
How far should it go in? To
the like right below the cert, like if you look at it.
Like how many millimeters?
2. So if you look at, that's how, at the end of the day, they should be sticking in like that much. So that means the head is like just a little bit below the surface. Now, before you do that though, you got to put on your...
Because the motor needs a pulley. So before you go inserting that, you need to put the pulley on with the same little Allen wrench. Tighten it up. Now, the key is how tight. And what we do there, just use a sheet of paper or a measuring tape. So don't bottom out the pulley. A little bit. Half a millimeter gap. Put your motor on, it should be right down the middle of the hole in your printed piece. That's the proof.
Yeah. Put all your spare parts that.
Where did you get those?
Garbage in a garbage can, spare parts in your box. Okay. Yes, I mean, literally, it's like a sheet of paper or a tape measure, like the broken tape measure that we have. Yeah, so like this, I use this to like get that underneath there too. That's how deep it should go, just that space. Yeah. Then when you mount that on your 3D printed piece, make sure the pulley's middle of the window. Does that make sense? In other words, the belt can be hidden in the sides of your 3D printed piece. Does that make sense? So when you look at the, it's right down the middle. The pulley's right down the middle. Not like up and down, like you can see the cogs of the pulley, they have to be in the hole. They can't be like up too far, down too far. Or your belt will be rubbing and you wear out your belt and your printer will break after some time. Yeah, so yeah, I'm gonna just like once I check the height, I'm just gonna do the. Yeah, we have Loctite too if you want to use it, but I would recommend the crazy glue on the top of the shaft, just a little drop. So I'll demonstrate here. So first of all, get it tight, get the pulley tight with the short, like this, the short end of the. So that means you can get a little bit more force, but don't like, not too hard, because you'll strip it. So just enough, you kind of get a, you need to get a feel for it, but don't go too hard. Like, if you do as hard as you can, you'll break that. It's a tiny, tiny little set screw, and it's aluminum. So, that. Okay, so I did that. I'm gonna do this thing. I'm gonna do crazy glue. Because you can still break it, you can just take pliers and twist it off, but I'm just going to do a little drop. Just a little drop, that's it. Just, huh? That's super glue, yeah, it's crazy glue. Methacrylate glue. But yeah, just squeeze it a little bit, just a tiny drop will do. So,
put it here.
So, question, which is the front? Is this the front, or is that the front? And I'm talking about the 3D printed piece. 10, which is the front. Why? Divider, yeah. And make the wire connection to the back, not the front. It's better that way. It doesn't matter. There, it doesn't really matter.
So, like, which of these lengths is like if I'm screwing in?
Yeah, that's right.
This one or like these ones? Like
just as it's got a couple of millimeters sticking out. Because once you screw down, it'll suck in to where it needs to go. Yeah, and there may be some, you might have to clear the holes a little bit to get those screws in. Yeah. The underside of those pieces is printed upside down, so that's why it's messy.
And where are the M3 drill bits?
So the M3 drill bits are the small ones here.
No, I'm sorry, the
driver?
Driver, yeah.
It's this bag here. It's an M2. You got one of those, didn't you?
Do you have one for this drill?
No.
You were saying if you hex it, it'll suck in.
If you hex it, it'll suck in.
Thank you.
don't tighten one screw at a time too tight. Put the other ones in and then tighten them all tight at the very end. Because if you do that, if you do one tight, you might not get the other ones in.
I still don't understand where we're supposed to put this glue.
Where?
Where do we put the glue on?
Oh, glue.
Should we put on before we screw it in?
Yeah. Yeah, you should. You can also use Loctite if you want, but I don't know. Because you can break this glue, like you can hold the shaft down, you can still break it, so it's not permanent. But it'll prevent your pulley from getting loose. Well, but look at it. So tighten it down. Tighten down first and look at it. Is it down the middle? So I tightened it and it's down the middle, so I'm good. I know it's good.
Did you put glue on it?
Yeah. I already did because I looked down the middle and I saw it was good. So I said, okay, I'll put the glue on.
Okay.
Thank you. All right, so now I'm going to tighten my rods. So you put the little screw into one of, there's three sets of holes. You can choose any hole. So I put the little, one of the little black screws, which looks like this, into one of these holes on the side. And I'm screwing it all the way through just to make sure it goes in. Then I back it out, and then, because I'm actually threading the hole. Like I'm, the hole is doesn't have threads printed in it, but I'm threading it effectively. So I'm gonna go like that, and I can tighten it down. There, and now it's tight. And that's an M3. It's easy to strip though, so you have three tries. I stripped one just now, so. So make it go all the way through before, without the rod first, to make sure it's, you kind of wore out the thread pattern into the plastic. If that makes any sense. And if you strip all of them, then you just crazy glue it.
Yeah,
well, just crazy glue.
I put the holes and just see the position of the
Just the bed axis, which is the Y.
Okay.
Because the other ones have a different motor mount. It's built into the base for the Z, and the X is this other piece.
Yeah, I sent them about four, 9 years. That's crazy when they feel the seat, that's crazy.
Now the other thing is if you strip out all your holes, it's also sufficient if you don't strip them out on the other side. You just have to hold the rod somewhere, because this will be attached to the base. Like that. So as long as you hold the rods from one side or the other, you don't want those rods to like slide in when the bed is moving. Slide with the bed. You gotta fix them to these pieces. Can we get the lights on here? Thank you. All right, that's better. Seen one of these?
No.
Well, it's one of the bags out there. Got a table there?
Go out there and grab yourself one of these. You
see how it looks? And then there's one that's like that, that's got 2 4 feet too, but it's shorter. It's on the table there.
Does it matter, yeah.
The black?
So you're, Wes, you're upside down on your thing.
Yeah, I was just going to look online for the configuration.
And your pulley is going, you can see it through the window? Like it's in the middle?
Yeah.
Okay. So a trick to threading those grub screw holes is this, and just do an M6 bolt into it, and now you have wound the threads. You have tapped the hole. So for the rods later with a grub screw. So now I have good threads in there, so I can do the same for the other hole. You can hold it. So it helps to do it better on the surface. Yeah. And they get hot too, so careful. Thank you. So for everybody, the quality control, when you look down the motor hole, is your pulley right down the middle. Prince, did you get to this step yet? Not yet?
No.
Yeah, so when you look at down it, you have to have the pulley just down the middle, the teeth of it. You can replace these things for the grub screws if you were out of grub screws, because this is a M6 as well. One less part count. Let's get to the belts before we go any further. If we've got this assembly or close to it, in your little bag there's tiny little bearings. They go in an idler, and then we can put the belt on. So how do you put the little two bearings in there, throw them in there, just kind of squeeze them through and then put a bolt from the bottom?
What are those for?
For the belt.
The belt.
The belt's going to go around that idler.
And you need a nut
on top of that.
Don't tighten that too hard or you'll pinch the bearings. They gotta spin freely. Alright.
Now
you can
there's the belt. It should go in a way that's accessible, so I would actually put the nut on the bottom so that if you got to unscrew it, you can unscrew it from the top.
Yeah.
If you're on this.
Yeah, but what I mean is, this doesn't have a top button,
just the side. Doesn't matter. If it's equally accessible, it doesn't matter. Symmetric. Belt for this, I would count it as 32 inches. I would cut 32 inch of belt. I'm ready for that.
Okay.
Yeah.
24.
How long can this extend? 18 inches.
What? 18 inches max.
Do we have longer or thicker rods?
Yeah. We have 1-inch rods.
And those extend how long?
4 feet.
4 feet. What? So we're building like farm bots, say. Farm bots like 8 feet.
Yeah. You can go with hollow 1-inch, which will, the 1-inch gets really heavy under its own weight. You could do hollow 1-inch and that would work maybe, that would work around 8 feet. Which one?
Well,
that was a torch table. The torch table. No, we never used them. Thank you. We got in the workshop. 34. Well, it depends which axis. The bed is 34. Thank you. Which side of the belt?
Yeah.
Peg is on?
Yeah.
Not sure. It's I think you want it to be I don't see a point right now.
Because I think on mine I've done all from the side of the
too tight?
No, from the I'm saying the ones that I did before, Indonesia. They're all coming from this side.
You want the peg on that side or no? This thing on that side?
I don't know. I'll try it on this side.
Okay. I'm working at this side for now. Needle file?
Yeah.
It's in the shop. You were using it there. No? Why not? You can just use a drill bit through it, but it doesn't have corners. Thank you.
Thank you.